Welcome to another Goody Reader review video. This is Marcus.
And this is Peter.
And today we're going to review the Pocketbook Pro 912. This is the second generation after the 902. Same stats hardware-wise as the 902 e-reader by Pocketbook. It has a 9.7-inch e-ink Visplex display. It has 1200 by 825 for the resolution, running at 150 DPI. The CPU kind of slow at 533 megahertz. It has 256 MB of RAM and 2 gigs of internal storage. And like all Pocketbook e-readers, it's running the Linux operating system. Of course, this does have Wi-Fi, which is one of the big selling points. And it is touchscreen, which really elevates Pocketbook's game by bringing it up to a modern e-reader that is capable of a touch display. And this is actually what makes it a little bit heavier than the original. It reads a ton of different e-book formats, PDF, EPUB, and it's compatible with Adobe Digital Editions. It also reads FB2, text, HTML, and a ton of others. And Peter here is going to show you off the hardware itself.
All right. Looking at it, you will notice it is pretty much the same as a Pocketbook 902. Differences on the very front is that it says education on the top right corner there. This is mostly because they're trying to cater towards users that use this for PDFs, textbooks, newspapers, things that really need a larger 9.7-inch screen. So moving on to the bottom, you have a hard reset button, 3.5mm headphone jack, status indicator light, micro USB, micro SD, and speakers on the bottom, stereo speakers.
And that, incidentally, that's one of the cool things about Pocketbook. In a world where hardware is getting cheaper and you're starting to see more e-readers come out with no onboard sound, such as the Nook Simple Touch, the Kobo Touch, and a ton of others, they try to save money and they're actually skimping out on a lot of the features that users want, which is, you know, onboard sound, built-in speakers, 3.5mm headphone jack for audio, music, and everything else.
Exactly. You have volume up, volume down, zoom out, and zoom in. On the top, this is where it gets a little bit different from the 902. Other than the power button here, you have a wireless on or off. So this is used to save battery. If you do not want the wireless connectivity on, you would slide that to the off position. Also, right here, you'll notice, as Marcus mentioned, it is touchscreen. So voila, you have yourself a stylus. And on the left side, there is nothing.
Now, with the stylus, we've noticed that if you want to take advantage of the touch screen, you do need to use the stylus exclusively.
Exactly. Now, this is a good and a bad thing, because if you do have a device that, for example, like the Asus EEE Note, we noticed that with that device, without the stylus, the device is entirely useless. Whereas this one, if you lose the stylus, for example, you're using this to interact with the touchscreen and you lose it, you can still interact with the device via the buttons. So you do have some usability even though the stylus is gone. So you are not completely bound by using that.
Okay, so this is the built-in interface. This is like your home menu. It's very much akin to what you've seen before. When you open up books, they'll appear here so you can quickly enter them. Clock, calendar, dictionary. It has text-to-speech support, so you can actually have either a male or female read these words and everything to you. It does have Wi-Fi, so you can surf the internet, and we'll show you the web browser and everything. It actually has HTML5 support, which I found was very interesting. So it is actually like a step in the right direction for Pocketbook with this device. So let's show you some of the features here, and first we'll get into the library. One thing that we did notice is the touchscreen and loading things up is actually pretty quick on here. Although it is quicker if you use like the D-pad, it's a little slower when you use the stylus to open up things, and it's quicker if you use the D-pad. So
exactly, this is mostly due with the very large screen being completely touchscreen and it only having a very limited processor and I think only 256 MB RAM. So there's a lot for the device to do with actually not the greatest of processing speeds. So if you find that it is slow, probably transfer over to the buttons itself.
Yeah, I mean, look how great the e-ink looks on here. It has superior resolution. And between this and a Kindle DX, I think I'm a more of a fan of the 912 here. I think it just has more bang for your buck.
Exactly. And I really like the addition of it actually being a large screen touchscreen device, and that's something you don't really see every day.
Exactly. So you can see page turn speed relatively quick. You do kind of have this refresh flash after every page. A lot of e-readers have the flash appearing every 6 pages, so if you can get past that, it's not too bad. If you click on the center here, you actually have a number of options, and so you could do voice, bookmark, dictionary, zoom, and such. So let's click on zoom and see how our ebook experience can be tailored. This is an EPUB book. And we will show you examples of like PDFs and things like that.
And as I've shown on the before when I was showing the actual device, there is a shortcut to zooming on the side. Unlike a lot of other e-readers, they do have the zoom up and zoom down buttons. So if you want to do a quick zoom without entering any actual screen, you can do so by pressing the buttons on the side.
Yeah, also you notice when Peter was switching it, it does go a full 360 degrees for the orientation. A lot of devices will have manual software-driven to switch from landscape to portrait mode, but Pocketbook actually has like a built-in gyroscope and accelerometer. So the added cost to the end user, you actually get a little bit more form and function where you don't really get that, say, with like a lot of the other 9.7-inch e-readers. Not that there's really, you know, that many of them. So this is pretty well like the EPUB experience here. Let's hit the home screen. And we'll take a look at some of the other features here. So we'll click on library again. So there's two PDFs I'm going to show you today. One's actually a newspaper. So this is an example of how great newspapers actually look on a large screen. So it fits a ton of stuff here.
Look at that formatting too. It's a side-loaded newspaper we put on this via a laptop, and it just formats so properly. It's amazing.
Yeah. So, I mean, this is readable. On a camera, it does look kind of small. So there's a lot of options here to zoom in. Obviously, you can't change the font because it's like an embedded font, but you could do reflow, which really helps. And instead of reading it on, well, okay, maybe that's not necessarily the best thing I just did there, but it's basically like trial and error finding out what, let's go to fit to width. Okay. It's pretty well like finding the sweet spot. So there really isn't any type of standard that you could do.
Let's just try. Now you'll notice that on a lot of e-readers, even small screen, big screen, you only get zoom 1, zoom 2, zoom 3. Look at all the options you get on the Pocketbook. And Marcus is correct. It is about finding the sweet spot with whatever you're setting out to read. So you can see that this did zoom it a little better. So it's all a sense of finding exactly what you wanna find here. Let's try like reflow 200%, for example. Yeah, so you're getting closer there. So if you find that this is pretty much standard to most actual newspapers that are published, so let's just go one step further and then we'll show you that. There you go. There's something a little bit better there for you.
Yeah, that's definitely easy to read. And so you kind of get rid of the tables and you can just flip. So again, if you're looking for an e-reader to read technical documents, newspapers, or something that was designed to read PDF files, this really does everything that you
definitely
need to do. So one of the other things that we'll look at here, um, What else? This is an example of a PDF version of a comic book.
This one does look like it'll probably need a, I'd say like 150% zoom to get the full experience of it.
Yeah, what? Looking at this, I think it's a scan comic book, and so it was in a comic book designed for the PDF format, so it probably doesn't look as great as...
Try a 150 zoom there, see how that looks. Yeah, so you get into it a little bit more, but as Marcus said, yes, not everything will format properly. You know, you have to make sure it's made for the device you're reading it on.
Yeah, exactly. But I mean, you saw originally how it was almost unreadable, but now it's like very readable. Let's just try 200%. Yeah. So again, it's finding a sweet spot, but you could see that in e-ink, everything looks really good. So this is the ebook experience. We'll look at, yeah, so this is pretty well. We've looked at newspapers, comics. We've looked at, ebooks. Let's just try looking at one of the ebooks that we've loaded on here. It's The Princess in a Tower. Oops. Here we go. This is something from Adobe Digital Editions imported in. So this is fully compatible with EPUB and PDF with Adobe, and you could use Calibre and things like that in order to copy books that you've downloaded from the internet. Very solid as far as like the text.
Look at all that reading space on a large screen.
Yeah, and I mean, I find myself more and more reading books on my iPad because I read books like later at night and stuff like that. So yeah, it doesn't really look like maybe there's like some bugs right now with the zoom button. I'm kind of hitting it and not much is happening. So again, this is not a commercial release. This is like this is a device that we've gotten direct from Pocketbook in their European office. So probably the firmware is not totally, you know, developed or anything yet. So I will cut it some slack in terms of not very many options for purchased ebooks.
Exactly. This is not a retail copy. This isn't exactly the experience you'll get right off the shelf.
Okay. So of course, like, because it takes the advantage of, of a touch screen, you can like write notes. There is some applications here for you. You notice that there is calculator, chess, clock, some pocketbook news, snake, and there is a web browser, which I find is something that lacked in other versions of the pocketbook e-reader. And if you're looking on the big differences between various versions of pocketbook's devices, we will give you a full review of it. So let's just show you how... Web browsing on e-ink devices is always an exercise of patience, but I'm glad that they did incorporate that.
And you will notice that the buttons are kind of staining as he types, and once again, this is not the copy that will be on Pocketbook's shelves. This is an exclusive pre-release unit that has been given to us to review.
Yeah. So it's going to take, it usually takes like a few seconds to load up here. So anyways, this is the web browsing experience. You can see that there's some errors. There are a number of like options for like to turn like HTML5 on and off. So you probably have to do some stuff, the web browser definitely needs some work. You can see I'm pressing the home button and not much is like happening.
You can still see the keyboard here, kind of.
Yeah. All right. So let's just see if we can get this going back to the home page. Okay, there we go. Web browser, I'm not too much of a fan of. I'm glad they have it, but you can see that, you did need a lot of patience to get that like set up properly. Of course, photos and music, we'll look into that right away and just kind of show you how it all looks. Pocketbook normally bundles their e-readers with hundreds of free e-books and pictures and music, so you can kind of get reading right away. You could load in all of your own content.
Another good thing about Pocketbook is that they pre-bundle their devices with just so many things. Songs, photos, books, everything. Look how that looks.
Yeah, I mean, amazing. And this is where 9.7-inch e-readers really shine. Just the resolution's phenomenal.
We're getting really far in there. Look at that.
Yeah, it's solid. So yeah, I'm in awe. That looks really nice. Let's try... let's get some music happening. And Peter's going to load all this sort of stuff up for us. I like... listen to audiobooks, MP3s on the go. It doesn't look like any default music was shown here. But it's a standard music player. It doesn't really have any EQ or anything like that, but having sound come out of the speakers is good. And even like the iPad only has a single speaker. This has dual speakers. So you do definitely get better quality sound out of this rather than just like the iPad. Let's just take a look at some of the final things here. You have dictionary, search. Let's just hit the configuration. Show you some of the options that they have here. Pocketbook's really known for giving you a lot of options to be able to tailor your device. So here's the model. Tells you all of the details. If we had an SD card, it would give you some of the info there. You can even say at startup, what do you want it to do? Maintenance, you can do firmware updates. You can change the keyboard, different user profiles, appearance. So wow, you got like lots of options here. Text rendering, you can even change that. It's quite excellent. Everything from the boot logo to like you can even lock the orientation if you want to. You can change like the interface fonts, and Pocketbook is really good about like allowing you a ton of bundled fonts. Like you can see that it has a ton of options here, more than most e-readers in the marketplace. You could actually load in your own fonts as well. So we'll just cancel that. So yeah, what are your thoughts on the new Pocketbook?
I really like the touchscreen. It's a very good addition, but truthfully, there's not too much else to say because the 902 and the 912 are exactly the same on the inside, except for this guy actually weighing about 25 to 30 grams more than the 902 because of the touchscreen. But there isn't too much to say really right now. I like that they have a web browser, although it's not finalized and they do need some work on it. I like the touchscreen, like I said. I like that if you don't have your stylus, you aren't completely locked out of the device. You still have all the navigation buttons to get yourself through. But it's very familiar to the 902. I think they're definitely heading in the right direction, especially with a large screen, almost 10-inch touchscreen device.
I would have liked to see the processor a little bit faster, and a 256 MB of RAM is not too much considering most devices are doing 512 to 1 gig now. I know that ups the cost, but it doesn't really up the cost by that much. And if I'm going to be paying $450 to $500, you know, I want a device that's a little bit faster. And so, you know, if having 1 gig of RAM added $50 to the cost, I'd gladly pay it. okay it, because 9.7 inch e-readers are very hard to find. There isn't really too many out there. And when you are looking at, say, the Kindle DX versus this, you're looking at the hardware specs, and I would pay $50 to $100 more if this had double of everything that the DX had. So I'm quite willing to pay that with the extra hardware. I do think this is a step in the right direction. I do think that the lack of RAM and lack of processor makes it suffer. But if you're using it exclusively just to read ebooks, that's fine. You saw that page turn speed on PDFs and EPUB books were pretty quick. With EPUBs, you didn't really get a chance to change any of the fonts. It's just, this is a pre-release. So I'm going a little bit easy on it. So hopefully with firmware updates, which incidentally, in the settings menu, there are options via Wi-Fi to automatically update the firmware, so you don't necessarily have to do in the past, which you had to copy it to your SD first and then ran the firmware updating. This is all done online, which makes it a little bit easy. So I would probably give this probably a good solid 7 out of 10. It needs work, but for what it is, it's pretty amazing. Okay, so this has been a review of the new Pocketbook 912 Pro 9.7-inch e-reader. For any other further reviews and videos, check out our YouTube channel at youtube.com/user/goodyreader, or you can check out our news blog at goodyreader.com/blog. And for goodyreader.com, my name is Marcus.
And this is Peter.
And everybody take care.